So last time we did the different steps of metallurgy. We finished the first three steps. So we finished the first, that is crushing of the ore. After crushing of the ore, we did concentration, right? So after crushing, we did concentration or enrichment. After that, we did extraction. This was extraction. We studied different types of methods used to extract the metal from the concentrate ore. And finally, we will do the fourth part, that is refining. This is the final step of metallurgy. So refining implies purification. So the extracted metal is finally purified to remove traces of impurities. Some impurities may have been present. So after extraction, also some impurities are left behind, which need to be finally removed to get the pure metal. The final step of removing the impurities to get the pure metal is called refining or purification of metal. One of the most common methods of refining is electrolytic refining, wherein electricity is passed to carry out the purification process. So electrolytic refining is the most common technique of refining. Okay. This much is sufficient for you at this stage. Now you need to know names of some ores, the common ones. So ores. Some common ores. Some common ores. So we will study different types of ores. You have to know the names of these ores. The first category is oxide ores. The first category is oxide ores. Under oxide ore, we have bauxite, bauxite is so the formula of bauxite is this. Then we have cuprite. Cu2O is the formula. Third one, magnetite. Fe3O4 is magnetite. Hematite, Fe2O3 is hematite. So common ores we are studying. These were under oxide ores. Next, sulfide ores. Sulfide ores. First, galena, PbS, lead sulfide is galena, zinc blend, suddenness. Cinnabar. Cinnabar is edginess. Third, carbonadones. First, limestone. Limestone calcium carbonate CaCl3. Calamine. CaCl3 is calamine. Halidos. Halide means chloride or bromide or iodide. First is carnallite, silver spar. On silver, AgCl is on silver. Sulfatos. Epsom salt. Anglesite. So these are some categories of ores that you have to know. Now, let's understand the next part of the chapter. Next part is called corrosion. Corrosion. So what is corrosion? Corrosion is a process in which the metal may react with atmospheric oxygen or atmospheric water, that is moisture. So gradually it will keep reacting and the metal will keep getting affected. That is, it will keep getting eroded. So this wearing away of the metal is called corrosion. This wearing away of the metal is called corrosion. Right. So the metals will wear away. They will wear away because they have reacted with the atmospheric oxygen and moisture. So this wearing away of the surface of the metal is called corrosion. So corrosion is definitely not desired. Corrosion is harmful because the metal will keep getting deteriorated. So it will keep getting deteriorated because of the reaction. So it's a natural process. It's a natural process wherein the metal undergoes oxidation or reaction with oxygen present in the atmosphere. So corrosion. It's a natural process. In which a metal reacts with atmospheric oxygen moisture carbon dioxide and hence the surface of the metal gets worn away. Corrosion is not desired. It is not desired because the metal will keep getting wasted. Right. So the metal will get corroded, and in this process, the metal will be lost eventually after a long period of time. The metal will no longer be present because it has permanently worn away. So atmospheric oxygen, that is air or water present in the environment, reacts with the surface of the metal to form a compound, and in this way the corrosion takes place. So more the reactivity of a metal, more will be the tendency to get corroded. The reactivity of the metal more would be the tendency to get corroded. Okay. Now let's understand corrosion of some common metals. So corrosion of iron. Corrosion of iron. So iron reacts with the oxygen and moisture. Present in air. So iron reacts with the oxygen as well as moisture present in the air to form hydrated ferric oxide. Hydrated ferric oxide. This compound form is called rust. Is called rust. And the corrosion of iron is called rusting. Corrosion of iron is called rusting. I have to understand the chemical equation. So this is iron. It reacts with oxygen. It reacts with some molecules of water. Form rust. What is rust chemically? Rust is Fe2O3.xH2O. This is called rust. This is called rust. This is called rust. So this is a balanced chemical equation for rust. Similarly, we can have corrosion of copper. Okay. Corrosion of copper. Copper reacts with carbon dioxide and water present in the air. Copper reacts with carbon dioxide water. Present in the air to form basic copper carbonate. Basic copper carbonate. this basic copper carbonate is green in color. Plus carbon dioxide plus water gives you this basic copper carbonate, CuCO3 dot CuOH twice. This is called basic copper carbonate. Basic copper carbonate. It's greenish. So sometimes they ask you in the exam, why does a copper substance turn green after some time or maybe after some years? It is due to the formation of basic copper carbonate. That means copper is getting corroded. So corrosion of copper leads to the formation of basic copper carbonate. Basic copper carbonate is what? Green in color. So if I have to balance this equation, then oxygen is also there. This is the equation. So you can see it's a balanced chemical equation, right? Okay. So it reacts with oxygen, water, and carbon dioxide. Present in the air to form basic copper carbonate, which is green in color. So this is corrosion of copper. So the Statue of Liberty in USA also has turned green because of this reason. So any material which is made of copper will undergo corrosion, and eventually after some years it will start appearing green in color. So if they ask you a question in the exam, why does a copper substance turn green? Remember that it is due to the formation of this substance, CuCO3.CuOH twice. You need to write down the chemical equation, that is the reaction, even if they don't ask for. Okay, next one. Corrosion of silver. Corrosion of silver. Silver reacts with hydrogen sulfide and oxygen present in the air. Form silver sulfide. Is black in color. So if I write down equation, this is the chemical equation. Silver will react with H2S. Plus oxygen. H2S plus H2O. So this is the equation. This is black. So silver's jewelry or anything which is made of silver turns black over a period of time. Maybe after many years, if you check its color, you will find that it has turned blackish. So black color is because of the presence of Ag2S. So it is due to the formation of silver sulfide, that is Ag2S. So this corrosion of silver. Thus, silver objects turn blackish. Over a long period of time. Corrosion of aluminium. So aluminium reacts with oxygen of air. Aluminium reacts with oxygen present in air to form a layer of aluminium oxide. On the surface of the aluminium object. So this layer of aluminium oxide is very tough. It is tough and it prevents further corrosion. The layer of Al2O3 form is tough and it prevents further corrosion. So the metal which is lying underneath, that is below the layer, will get protected from further oxidation. Why? Because already it has been covered with a layer of aluminium oxide. This layer formed will prevent the metal lying below from further corrosion. About aluminium, the corrosion of aluminium. Now, there is a concept called galvanization in order to prevent or rather slow down rusting. Galvanization. So what is galvanization? This is a method to prevent rusting of iron. The surface of iron is coated with zinc. The surface of iron is coated with zinc. And therefore, this is what happens. See, zinc is more reactive than iron. And so, zinc being more reactive than iron reacts. Zinc being more reactive than iron reacts with oxygen and moisture present in atmosphere. In this way, zinc gets oxidized and iron gets protected. So this is called galvanization. It's the process of coating zinc. An iron object with zinc is called galvanization. So this is galvanization. Next part of the chapter, alloys. So this is the last portion of the chapter, it is alloys. Now what is an alloy? First of all, an alloy is a homogeneous mixture. An alloy is a homogeneous mixture. It may contain two or more metals or it may contain a mixture of metals and non-metals. A mixture of non-metal and metals. But an alloy can never be composed of only non-metals. So an alloy will definitely have at least one metal, but it will never have only non-metals. It will have at least one metal. Along with that metal, you can have other metals or you can have non-metals. But it will never be having only and only non-metals. So what are the objectives? What are the objectives of making alloys? The objectives of making alloys are first, to increase resistance to corrosion. To increase the resistance to corrosion. To increase resistance to corrosion. To modify the chemical reactivity. Increase the hardness. Increase the hardness. Increase the tensile strength. Tensile strength and to lower the melting point. These are the different purposes of making alloys. Some common alloys you have to know. Some common alloys. Some common alloys. Number one, duralum. Things. So what are the elements that it contains? It contains aluminium, copper, magnesium, and manganese. Duralum. It is stronger than pure aluminium. So duralum is stronger than pure aluminium. It is light and strong. Is light and strong. It is used for making bodies of aircrafts. It is for making bodies of aircrafts. Second layer. Magnesium. Gadolinium contains aluminium and magnesium. It is very light and hard. Used for making light instruments, balance beams, Alnico. It contains aluminium, nickel, cobalt, and iron. It is magnetic in nature. It is magnetic in nature. And it can be used for making magnets. Next is brass. It contains copper and zinc. Is more valuable than pure copper. This is for making utensils, this is for making cooking utensils, pipes, screws, etc. The next one is bronze. Bronze comprises of copper and tin. bronze is made up of copper and tin. It is very tough. And resistant to corrosion. So bronze is very resistant to corrosion. That is one of its biggest advantages. It is used for making utensils. Statues, coins, etc. Another alloy which is very resistant to corrosion is German silver. Comprises of copper, zinc, and nickel. Copper, zinc, and nickel. Is resistant to corrosion. It is used for making utensils. It is used for making utensils. So these are the different alloys that I used. You have to know the names and composition of these alloys. Composition in the sense, the substances which are there. And steel, if just steel is given, that is also steel. Steel. steel is an alloy of iron and carbon. Stainless steel. Is resistant to corrosion. So highly resistant to corrosion. What is it used for? It is used for making kitchen accessories, cutlery. And different other types of utensils. That's it. So these are the important alloys that we must know. These 8. We complete metals and non-metals. With this we complete metals and non-metals. Anybody has any doubt? any of the reactions of any chapter. Since the topic of this chapter, maybe she can ask doubts. Remember the reactions, whatever reactions we have done in this chapter are extremely important. All reactions have to be known. You cannot skip any reaction. Now the third one, look at the third alloy. Alnico. You can remember its constituents in this manner. Al for aluminium, that is Al. Ni is nickel. So Alnico is cobalt, Co. So Alnico, and along with aluminium, nickel, and cobalt, you have Fe also. So Al is aluminium, Ni is nickel, and Co is cobalt. Aluminium, nickel, cobalt, and iron. These are the four components of alnico. So from the name itself, we can figure out what the elements are in it. Rusting of iron is very important. So corrosion of iron also called rusting of iron. This rust which is formed is red in color. Red, I shouldn't say red, it is reddish brown. Or just brown this is. So reddish brown. Reddish brown in color. So what is rust? Rust is Fe2O3.xH2O. It is chemically called hydrated ferric oxide. So it is brownish. So all chemical equations have to be balanced, that we have balanced them. It is also mandatory to write plus XH2O. Value of X is not known, it's variable based on the years of exposure, the time period for which the iron object has been exposed, the value of X will change. So one important question from this is, why is Statue of Liberty greenish? So remember that Statue of Liberty has undergone corrosion. Why? Because it is made up of copper. Statue of Liberty looks green because of corrosion of copper, so you can take this as a question. Why does answer? Statue of Liberty. It is made of copper. And copper has undergone corrosion. Copper has undergone corrosion. Thereby forming basic copper carbonate. Which is green. So this is the reason. With this we complete the chapter. Metals and non-metals is over. The next lecture will start with the next chapter.